Welcome back. Volume 3, Third Strike.
Woo! It's a party.
Some of us are a little bit more excited than the others, but that's all good. My name is Ken Navarro, and to my right,
Jeff Biancalana, animator and sometimes storyboard artist for Happy Tree.
Voice of Russell.
Voice of Russell and Buddhist Monkey.
Alan Lau, director of Buddhist Monkey and animator on Happy Tree Friends.
Lila Warren, animator on Happy Tree Friends.
Ken Pontak, writer and drunkard, not always in that order.
Usually drunkard and then writer.
Warren Graff, writer, not drunkard. Voice of Handy, voice of Toothy, and that's it.
And sometimes ants.
Sometimes ants when necessary.
John Simino, animator, Happy Tree Friends.
Ellen Connell, did voiceover for Cub.
Jason Sadler, I'm animator.
Julie Stroud, the producer of Happy Tree Friends.
Jim Lively, sound designer.
Yeah. We welcome you all and to basically half hour of us kicking it.
So join us, won't you?
Exactly.
Kick back, put your feet up, enjoy.
Relax.
We're going to kick until it bleeds.
So what are we watching?
It's a little show called Happy Tree Friends, Warren. I don't know if you're familiar with it.
No, I like Japanese anime.
What are
they
doing to that cow?
So this episode's called Milking It, and on the right side you'll see Jeff Biancalana with beautiful boards.
Thank you, sir.
Which he did twice.
Actually, based this on a real event, I actually stole a cow in my youth. And trying to get away in a hot air balloon. It's terrible.
It's no fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, we were trying to brainstorm this, and we were thinking, what could they get away with? What is the silliest thing that they could use as a getaway vehicle?
I said car. That seemed ridiculous.
A clown car.
A clown car would have been perfect. Where were you, Ken?
I wasn't here yet. I had nothing to do with this.
He was at home.
Drinking.
Drinking milk, perhaps?
There was milk in it.
Or was it just milky?
It was milky
substance. Fluid, actually. Milky substances.
There was milk in the refrigerator next to it. And that's the first episode. Thank God!
We heard they talked about it.
Still here?
There's credits.
Credits. Okay. Credits, it's people read them.
That's what they're there for.
Do we record on the credits?
What a concept! The credit!
You'll notice them throughout the show.
This is Out of Sight, Out of Mind, which I think is one of the most beautiful shows we've ever done. The colors are great, the animation. We had a lot of time to do this, Jeff.
Yeah, we actually had quite a bit of time. Jenny Hansen really rocked those colors in this one.
And for you Happy Tree Friends aficionados out there, you'll notice that this pan that we're watching right now was not part of the original episode that went out over the web. We had intended to do that pan originally, but since with web constrictions and such, and it just was not working whenever we tried to play it back. So we figured we'd save it for the DVD.
Woo, special feature.
Aren't you guys
That's
glad
worth
you
the money
up?
Right
exactly.
There.
All, yeah.
All the money you wasted on broadband. That $50 a month, you couldn't even get that. $10, you get this on your DVD.
Who explained the episode? You explained the story to me. Wasn't there little post-its?
Somebody made something up quick.
For the love of God, is anybody in the room?
I'm sorry, I stepped out for a little.
I was drunk.
David Wynn, who is the animator on the show.
Too late now!
We were struggling. We'll cut it in later, okay?
Actually, I did one of these trick-or-treats right here. That's what I recall.
You did!
Yeah.
That's right. You were giggles.
What was the story?
David Wynn. Oh, sorry. on the sidetrack, though. David Wynn was one of the animators on this episode. We were struggling with what to do for this Halloween episode. We knew we wanted to make it really special, and he came in one day basically with just a stack of post-its, and he had it all figured out. He came in, he goes, "I got it, you guys." And we went to the conference room, and he put up all his post-its. And I knew then that I knew today that man was insane.
That's when you bought him all that pads of paper for
exactly.
Large size.
And did any of his storyboards end up in the final product?
Yes, it did. Most of it did. 70% of this is what David Wynn actually pitched us.
Because that story would have been funnier if you said, and we threw out all the post-its.
Well, then we threw out all the post-its.
That's funny!
You can see David's post-its in the Follow the Yellow Rabbit feature on this DVD. A little self-plug there.
credits.
But yeah, going back to, I've always wanted to do an episode with Mole, Mime, and Handy in a car on a road trip together. I think that writes itself, really. Just go.
In fact, everybody at home, just imagine the episode. You're welcome. Just give us credit.
Send money for it.
Yeah.
Please send money for it. This is a class act, and this we wanted, again, for Christmas, we wanted to do a really special episode. We tried to involve the whole cast in this one, something really epic.
Yes, and we made up some characters to fill in this one.
Yeah, those weird blue-looking happy tree generic people.
If you guys hear any loud thumps, it's just one of us passing out because it just got to about 120 degrees in this room.
That's how we like to keep it here at Mondo.
On the bright side, the bread's almost done.
And those eggs are cooked.
The eggs are cooked.
Those aren't eggs.
We'll just leave it at that.
Imagine for yourself.
So we're all naked here at Mondo all the time.
So I'm wearing a banana
That's
hat.
How we keep our sense of humor.
Wait, we have a sense of humor?
I always like Lumpy telling him to continue. Lumpy's just like, go on.
Keep going.
And what I like is every time they rephrase that tune, the pianist makes it higher and higher and higher.
Yeah, try singing it.
This is the birth of Pizza Face.
There's
right
pizza
there.
Pizza Face.
Pizza Face.
Which you thought was such a great gag. We had, originally we had Pizza Face actually happen in the pizza parlor.
Yeah.
And they would throw that, it was Mole, and he would throw the pizza and the face around.
I think we just saw the idol.
Yes,
I did.
Yeah.
First idol signing.
Drink. Drinking game. Anything's a drinking game for me, of course, but for you at home, if you take a drink every time you see the idol, you may become intoxicated.
Ken's drinking game is every time you see something, drink.
Drink.
Until you can't see anymore or feel the pain.
And when you can't see anything,
success.
Drink.
And the introduction of Slinky Face.
And there's Slinky Face.
He walks downstairs alone or in bed.
Pizza Face's partner. Goes out, they go out and solve crime together.
It's a HTF Miami. Exactly. CS, you know that show that's really popular? We don't want to say that'll sue us.
Tribute.
Some really great acting here. But
this is sort of the emotional climax of Happy Tree.
Amazing. Put your DVD remote on slow and just watch all the characters.
Get a box of Kleenex.
There's a lot of stuff going on there in the background. It's really fun.
I love how Flaky's shivering because she's cold because her skin has been... What should I say? Her skin.
I love the crying eyes. I love when their eyes get like big and like puppy dog eyes.
It's the ultimate question.
And just in that warm moment of peace.
It's just sad that big stump that they found, it probably took them forever to cut that tree down and haul it away. I mean, it must have been huge.
It's all burned up now.
It's all over.
Good times. That's good times in Happy Tree Friends Land.
It is. Good times.
And here's some more credits, Warren. Just for you.
Oh, see, there you go. See, drink.
We're trying to deliver. Trying to give, you know, give back.
We're all about reading here at Happy Tree Friends.
It's educational.
The way you make me wheel. We had that concept of Lumpy shaving in a car, which I thought was hilarious for a long time.
Ken's had that concept since I've known him, like the past 5 or 6 years.
And how long have you known him?
Like 2 years. We gotta work on that joke.
Damn.
You said two.
Timing,
three.
Dude. We'll talk about this later.
Just cut that out.
Ducks were a really funny addition here. Originally, he was supposed to swerve and miss the ducks and hit a whole schoolyard of kids.
See, that gets laugh.
That's funny. You know, I mean.
Damn. Missed that joke.
I'm surprised more people don't do that. What do I know?
Coming up is the introduction of, if you'll notice, Happy Tree, everybody has, whenever they have cars, they have very distinct cars. Like, Lumpy always has that old beater, and Handy, this is Handy's first appearance with his car.
You know what's funny is that they have real cars here, but in Wheelin' and Dealin', they had, like, tree trunk cars. Get off me! Hey!
The show's come a long way, Warren.
I guess
technology has improved.
Mondo got a bigger budget. They're able to get real
cars.
Exactly.
We're going to get real cars this time.
I love how pale. Yeah, I love how pale he gets. I think it's all kind of woozy.
That's a good feeling.
Yeah.
I put a shifter in there originally with numbers and letters on it. We had to take that out because
they
don't exist in the Happy Tree world.
They're illiterate.
Except in one episode.
Oh.
And when Ken animated this, there was a funny thing about Handy going around the wheel.
We weren't sure about that episode. We kept talking about it, and we were like, I'm not too sure about this, how this is going to work. And then we're just like, well, what if he got caught in the wheel, and he's all flop, 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 and we all just busted up laughing.
Let's make it.
Basically, if we laugh for, 3 seconds at something really hard, it's in. We're easy.
That was a long night, too.
Yeah.
Brainstorming.
And flop, 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 flop. Rain drizzling until that point.
Epic Happy Tree episode here.
Oh, yeah.
Splendid.
Again, we wanted to do a very big kind of superhero type. We haven't really used Splendid in that fashion, and we really wanted to stretch his superhero legs.
He's really probably one of the more domestic superheroes.
We do make a point whenever we come in on one of these Splendid episodes that we make sure that he's doing something very domestic, like sewing or baking and all this kind of...
And it just goes to show that it's cool to cook. And it's cool to sew. Because if somebody like Splendid can do it...
Hey, it is cool.
I'm just trying to say that you should cook me dinner once in a while.
Hey, no domestic problems during the recording.
Sorry, you can sew me some pants. It's hard to walk around with no pants, man.
But the ladies, no. ladies. Jeff B in the house.
And there was the bee just 2 seconds ago.
Jeff B is in this episode when Giggles is running through the flowers. There's a little bee flying around, if you noticed.
He's dubbed my name, Jeff B.
Yeah, and Handy was able to see this. Toothy was able to see that meteor, from far away.
But he's then got really good eyes.
Except not when it's coming at him really fast. But I don't want to give anything away.
Hey, he's farsighted.
Most beavers are.
So are they.
Scientific fact. Fun fact. Little known fact.
Education.
Look out. Look, he's looking. Squint.
This is great.
Boom. It's just such a great impact.
Back at home.
And he opens it up, and it's burned.
No! Which really isn't an overreaction, because, everybody hates burnt bread.
Yeah.
You got to scrape off all that crust. It's just a hassle.
It's a nightmare.
And here's there.
I don't want to think about it.
Great homage to... another big superhero.
Batman.
Hulk.
Razorback, I think.
Razorback. If you know who that is,
you're one of us.
You need to get outside. Right now, all over America, people are looking, Googling Razorback.
Marvel's going to start. The Serious Gangsters are going to have so many hits all of a sudden.
All of a sudden, we got a million hits.
Razorback is hot.
Bring him back.
Bring him back.
Is there some way we can control a trend through this voiceover and make money? Some stock tip we could slip through? Or work on that.
Yes, buy big on soy. It's making a comeback. What are we on?
I get a trick out of you.
Oh, thanks, Jeff. Ah.
You're welcome.
Can I add that it's not only hot in here, but beginning to smell as well?
That's Jeff without his pants. That usually happens.
It's amazing how much odor pants keep in.
Especially rubber pants.
This is great. This is an episode animated by Jason Sadler and John Cimino.
It's a great career.
This is one of Jason's scenes with a nice little acting here with Lumpy. It's very fun.
Yeah, Lumpy's really animated in this one. Sometimes he's really animated, but this one he's doing his little dance there. He's
really,
like,
really,
he's really
Do you mean animated as opposed to live action?
I don't know.
And again, for you geeks out there, there's Lumpy's wearing a very special pendant that... if you're on Google anyways, you should
I'm a superhero site.
You're the only one that knows who that is, too. So all you geeks in here.
I never
basically
know
so I can go home and go, dude, check it out! That's awesome!
And they're like, Ken, we still don't know what you're talking about.
Now you're speaking my language. Have a couple of drinks, maybe then you'll know.
Okay.
Ken drank them all.
Yeah, this was a fun sequence. Originally, we were going to have... Lumpy was going to tightrope walk across the guts to get back in.
It's sort of an homage to Buster Poindexter. We like the classics.
Sure, whatever warrants it.
I don't.
There's more buildings made out of trees.
Giant trees.
Because in Happy Tree Friends Land, when they see a giant tree, they think, let's chop it down and make a building out of it.
All the way that wood, burn it.
That thing's been here for eons.
They hate the old growth.
And they plant new little trees. They like to feel superior.
There's a little, for more Happy Tree Friend aficionados, that bouquet was the same bouquet we used in the Giggles Smoochie. Which caused her brain to pop out.
So on the boards on the right, it's Toothy, and then Cuddles is in the animation.
Jim!
Shut up!
I just noticed. Locked I hadn't seen that
behind
before.
The curtain.
Mental note of Jim Cuddles later.
Take Snake on the Uddles. We're going to have to get Jim to edit Jim out of this.
I heard from the dailies that Cuddles is a screen hog, but...
But he's so awesome.
Cuddles in the house.
Well, actually, a lot of times when I'll board these episodes, we won't have all the characters figured out yet, and I'll just draw some either a generic-y looking character, and we'll figure it out later, or Toothy. Jason Sadler yet again.
He's sort of monopolizing the episodes.
But not the
conversation.
They're
like the mafia of animation.
They were sort of selfish when it came to animating.
They would just come around and harass all the other animators.
Basically how the procedure goes here, Mom,
is
they would go, okay, who wants to animate this? They'd first ones with their hands up. And we do! We do!
If you want to. Again, no domestic, no domestic problem.
We weren't going to announce it till later, but you know.
This came out really fun. Basically, we just kind of had the idea of getting kind of all these glass injuries and just kind of ran with it. There's a lot of fun stuff in the background, too, there that are either tool-related or hand-related somehow. They're kind of funny, like the barbells and the hand grip.
Get it? It's ironic. We crack ourselves up.
Maybe a little too much.
On these backstories, drawing.
This is great too. In the Warren almost choked to death recording this,
and destroyed about $10,000 worth of sound equipment.
We have again a shameless plug in the same DVD. If you go to the special features of the Follow the Yellow Rabbit, you'll see Warren actually choking himself. Good times. Let's all laugh at him.
That's not you won't actually see me choking myself. You'll see me choking on water.
He's actually choking a small kitten while he's choking on the water. But he just
well worth myself. The admission of coming in here.
That's worth three DVDs, if you ask me.
That was really fun. That turned out really well.
Yeah, that was good
times. If you
good,
do say good, so good, yourself.
If we do say so ourselves.
And we did.
Just now, it's on tape.
You're saying it again. That's right.
I'm saying that in my review of the DVD that I'm going to publish. Greatest DVD. I'm not going to say it, so we don't get sued.
I might comment on that on the commentary on the commentary.
This is a pop and cob.
Look at all the walking they're doing.
Yeah, Ken likes to put lots of three-quarter walk cycles in his storyboards, which I get to animate. Thank you very much, Ken.
Now you know why I put it in there.
You love it. Kids at home, just check out how much walking is in this episode.
Can this we is the walking long episode. Shot, please?
Yes. Long shots for everybody. Thanks, Ken. Crazy walking turnaround.
For Ken decided he wasn't going to do any more animating.
That's it.
Just telling people what to do.
This came out really... really well. Aubrey did the voice of Pop. And again, shameless plug, it's in Follow the Yellow Rabbit feature.
And he's right there!
So I got to do some underwater screaming for this too, but I'm a method actor, so I was pretty worried about this scene. Ken decided he needed to dunk my head in the water over and over.
Bury you in sand.
You gotta get the shot. You gotta get the
exactly.
scene.
Exactly.
We got it to sound just right.
You have to get it just right. Exactly. Ellen was a trooper.
Yeah. It wasn't too cold, so that's good.
Ken, I wasn't doing any voices at all. Why were you dunking my head?
Well, you know, we had to get the feeling of
he's
it.
A method director.
Exactly.
And he had to practice before he actually got it.
Okay.
At least the smell is taking my mind off the heat.
And your lack of pants, Jim. If you had pants on, I'd sit down. But I'm not sitting down on the floor.
Fine, next time I'll wear pants.
Here's Ellen seeing as she happily drowns.
That's right.
What a trooper.
It's all for the art.
Did you record this at the beach? Underwater?
We did, actually. Over at Ocean Beach. It's really freezing.
There you're in the sand, yeah. Waited for the tide to come in.
And go.
It's a short window of opportunity, but I think it comes out on the screen.
The underwater mic worked just beautifully.
We had to do a lot of takes, but it was worth it. The salt water, I think, helped the wounds heal faster.
It did. It's painful in the process, but...
And the crabs picked away all that loose flesh.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Who needs loose flesh? Come on.
It's loose for a
reason.
Exactly.
It's overrated.
If it was permanent flesh, it wouldn't be
permanent
loose.
No one wears permanent flesh anymore.
I'm molting. What can I say?
Oh, this is out on a limb. One of my new favorites, I think.
Because it's simple, yet disturbing.
The way I like my women.
Based on your...
I thought you were like, you would have drunk. Oh, that's you drunk.
Drunk, simple, and disturbing.
It's based on real, true events.
This is based on actual events.
Based on a Happy Tree Friends moment.
A real life one, yeah.
When we originally kicked around this idea, we had so much stuff going on here that we were kind of riding ourselves in a hole.
The Tyrannosaurus Rex for no reason?
Yeah.
He had like a glass of water and it had that Jurassic Park moment where the some water came out like boom, boom. And like he'd look at the trees and be moving, he'd be stuck there.
He was fighting off lions with a chair and a whip.
Yeah.
And clouds and bees.
Like, yeah, the bees and the bugs. He got all infected.
Thinking it had nothing to do with having your leg pinned by a tree.
But then we kept trying to keep it. We were like... We can make it go real fast. We can do a montage.
We tried really hard. And after we slapped Warren a couple of times, we figured it out.
We called up the guy who actually did end up cutting off his limb when he got caught. And he said he didn't fight bees or bears or any of that stuff. So
we said, boring!
This story isn't worth telling.
Yeah, I'm telling the story of a wuss.
Cry, baby.
Oh, I cut off my arm. Oh, boo-hoo. Some really good sound design in here by Jim Lively with the bone breaking and crunching.
I actually downloaded an article and read it to make sure that I had the details right.
And we brought him in. We flew him in.
Yeah.
And he showed us on his other arm.
And you videotaped it.
And we videotaped it.
We recorded it, too. Yeah,
we motion captured it.
You know, we should hunt him down and send him a copy
of
this.
That's the most horrible thing the motion... Did you get it? No, we didn't have the computer on. Do it again.
You have two legs?
I think we get the same feel from
my there's
leg.
The gag. Oh. He cut off the wrong leg. Oh, that's really sad.
Lumpy.
Luckily, he has a paperclip.
I just noticed Lumpy doesn't wear pants either.
Okay, we get it. You want to be lumpy.
Jeff, none of them do.
Except for Pantsy. But he wears too much pants.
Excuse me, Disco Bear wears pants. Thank you very much.
You know, Lumpy doesn't really die, huh? You're not really sure if he dies in that one.
Oh, he'll die.
That's true. We leave that to your imagination.
Is Lumpy the only one with nipples?
For now. Actually, the original Shifty, Lifty and Shifty had nipples when they would...
Do they have superfluous nipples or just two?
Just two.
Because yeah. I have a superfluous nipple right here.
It's in his pocket.
Yeah. It's not mine. I found it.
This is Keeping It Real.
Keeping It Real.
Wanted to do a movie theater?
Yeah, we were just, it was like 10 hours of not knowing what to do and starting to argue and fight over
little,
it.
Little Buddhist monkey shout out there.
Going at each other's throats.
Warren said, hey, what if they're in a theater?
No, it was more like an angry. It was just like, fine, what if it's just in a movie theater then?
I wanted to soften the anger part because that was ugly.
No, I like the anger.
It's like keeps watching fresh. A movie
keeps it real.
City.
Oh! Yeah, nobody got that.
That was a good, here's a great gag. Really well done by Jason Sadler. Very well executed.
Popcorn head.
Popcorn brain.
And what research did you do for this, Jason?
A lot of movies.
A lot of popcorn?
Asking the guy behind the counter,
what would happen?
You stabbed me! Ten people
with
behind you.
With a notepad. I don't know, sir. Are you going to order something?
What a supersized man.
Security.
Please don't pester me. I only make...
It's a great sequence here by John Simoneau.
Yeah, this is one of our favorites.
This is one of our favorite gags here when the film burns on his eye.
And there was another episode that was born in this episode that you'll see later.
ICU.
ICU.
That's right. We had the concept for ICU while we were coming up with this. We thought that there would be a Slurpee machine in the lobby.
And it just became its own.
It became its own. They walked off and said, I'm out of here.
Yeah. Yeah, when it's going good, it's going good. When it's going bad,
it's going
ugly.
Bad.
You don't want to be anywhere near us.
Oh, hard enough to swallow. This is the debut episode of animation team of Lila Warren and Sam Hood.
Woo!
Yeah!
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 Unfortunately, it's their last
episode. And nice work, Olivia.
Some great and actually there.
Oh.
Hilarious. Hilarious stuff.
Yeah, the method ants.
Method ants. Really good ant stuff here, too.
The ant SWAT team was sort of how we came about from this, because we just thought it was funny to see a crack commando unit of ants like going with their hand signs and like their leader and stuff.
Here's the ant family all coming together,
banding
together.
Her hat right there with the ace. Ah, it's so good.
That's how you know who's the leader.
Yeah, that's how you know who's the leader. See, they're good. She didn't even hear it coming. There's no need to break the teeth, but you know what?
It's funny.
It's good.
Funnier.
Why not?
Originally, we had the idea that they would come down, or when they came down, there would be all these refugee ants.
Of all the ants from the past. Yeah. Like, he doesn't digest them. Just, they live down there as refugees.
This is another one that we spent a lot of time figuring out how they were going to get out from inside of him.
Yeah, we started, we were like, well, they'll just have some C4. Too easy.
A bunch of Alka-Seltzer.
We don't like to take the easy route here.
Yeah. We like to make it more difficult.
Alka-Seltzer was pretty good,
yeah,
but I think the heart one
Exploding
that Ken,
heart.
You came up with was
well,
really
thank
good.
You.
Yeah.
Here's great slide there that Warren came up with.
Thank you. I worked hard on that one.
I mean, it was just okay.
It was like 20 pages. I just was writing and writing and writing. And then the last thing I wrote was inflatable slide. Yes.
That's always the last thing you write, though.
It finally worked my sign off.
Yeah.
Is that your old dancing
That's
name?
My name, yeah. It's my porn name.
So Jeff isn't the only one who's not wearing pants around here.
Oh, I wear my pants. It's not free. I get paid.
Water slide episode. Beautiful colors here by Jennifer Hansen, doing all the colors for
boo
all of the episodes.
I fought hard to put Lumpy in a banana hammock.
You just wanted to spend all our brainstorms saying banana hammock.
You did.
Those are two funny words.
Better, great. Funnier together.
Here's a giggles witnessing some. Oh. Always being the witness to Lumpy's nakedness for some weird reason.
I thought that was Jeff.
Yes, we heavily referenced Jeff.
I posed for that.
We motion captured him. That's actually his butt.
Put all those little dots on him. Who painted the dots on him?
Jeff did.
He painted his own dots.
He painted his own dots. Again, animated by Jason Sadler, Ted Pratt, and John Simoneau.
Bang up job.
You pulled in every animator you could.
Yes, we sucked them all up in the Bay Area.
This
like
episode,
a bloody sponge.
This episode was inspired by stories that Ken would tell us of water slides, of how people just jack up things people would do to water slides that we can't talk about. So we're not going to be blamed for that. But if you contact us later, maybe
yeah. We'll. Email water.
What we were saying, if you buy 15 DVDs, tell you. I'll bring you all the necessary things that you
Warren
need.
Will come over to your house and stalk you.
Whether you like it or not.
Yes.
I'll probably do that anyway. So, buy the DVDs.
Or get a restraining order now.
Yeah, you might as well get a blank restraining order, put my name in, and just we'll fill out the dates when I get there.
We'll put that in the package.
So this is the episode that came out of Keeping It Real with Nutty, because Ken had always been talking about Nutty Vision, like if you got a brain freeze.
Yes, I've always wanted to do that. We had that brain freeze idea with,
for a long time. He was like forcing it in the weirdest places. It was like class act. What if in the back there is a Slurpee machine and Nutty all of a sudden goes back? No.
But it finally worked.
Finally it worked. And now,
I knew it would. One day.
I could go for a Slurpee right now.
I could, wish I could bathe in some Slurpee right now. So.
This is also the debut episode that Edward, Brad, and Alan worked on. Oh. Alan's first legit Happy Tree Friends episode.
Yes,
Alan. I'm sorry.
Again, last episode.
Outside of Bonus Monkey.
Now, what is an illegit episode?
The ones that get sent away and we don't talk about.
That we don't talk about. Yes.
I like that close-up of his face.
Turn around.
But I like his face coming to the camera when he first rips it off. His like head is like seems extra big, like it's like right there.
You guys notice that turnaround there? Alan animated that, and it's kind of difficult to do in Flash, and it started a little
turnaround revolution.
War here.
It was turn things around here at Mondo. So.
There was a turnaround battle that went on here. Alan did this scene, and he had Nutty turn around, and we were so excited about it that Jeff angrily went over to back to his workstation.
I believe Ken said, "In your face, Jeff!"
No. I said, "In your face,
Jeff!" Basically challenging
the
me.
Please don't misquote me.
Try to keep up with the amazing Alan Lau here. So, and then Lila got pulled into it too. So dragged into it.
All three guys came up to my desk. No pressure, but...
How could you guys keep up, though? His first name is Amazing. Amazing Alan.
Wow. It's a new drinking turnaround game.
So you guys can see how many turnarounds you can find in this
episode. I don't notice that there are none in my section.
You didn't get none didn't step up to it.
Absolutely against turning around.
Again, beautiful boards by Jeff Biancolana there on the right side.
Thank you, sir.
I wasn't even noticing the boards. I stopped looking.
There's the idol.
Yeah, thanks, Warren.
I mean, beautiful boards.
And most of the designs here were made by Jeff and Lila.
It's only 2 inches tall. I can't see both.
So, Ken, you basically say you didn't do anything with this episode.
Nope.
Is that what you're saying?
It was completely Ken-free.
Ken became a real director and actually didn't touch any of it.
I transcended.
That's it.
I was like, here you guys, just finish this.
He became a writer instead of a writer-director.
Here's the turnaround coming up. Not just once, but drink. Twice!
Two drinks.
But wait, it ain't over yet, folks.
There was a turnaround from Cub, too.
There was a turnaround from Cub, that's right. And there's another one here.
Oh!
Reverse angle.
Now it's just getting gratuitous.
That's Apple Core head. Which will join Slinky Face and Pizza Face.
As a special guest.
Exactly.
So like,
second season, we'll bring him back in. He'll replace one of the ones who retires, I think.
He'll be sort of like the undercover guy. Nobody recognizes him.
Now that's funny.
That's one of my biggest fears. I can only sleep on a block of wood.
I thought it was a bed of nails.
Love the cap. All right.
And I think that's it.
That's it. Thank God we can breathe again.
Oh, air.
Hey, where's my pants?
I need a drink.
I think your pants are on eBay.
So that's it.
Hopefully you had as much fun as we had just kicking it.
Probably
watching
did.
These episodes. And hopefully you'll come back for the fourth DVD.
And the fifth.
And the sixth.
And maybe
buy our t-shirts.
Maybe you learned a little something.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Maybe you just grew.
Maybe you learned just to read or bit. Learned how to turn a character around.
How to get out of an anteater.
So that's what we're here for, is to enrich your lives.
Education.
It's all about education.
This DVD meets the educational requirements set by the United States of America. Not.
And that note. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye. Bye.